And so, it came to pass that Odin, the god-king of Valhalla and Asgard, created the Viking people, shaping them in the form of gods. Odin found pleasure in their creation, but saw that there was no space for his children in Valhalla, so he created the earth. The gods loved their children, and at first, contact between the two races was frequent. Eventually, it came to pass that the gods tired of their children, and visitations became less frequent. According to Viking legend, the age of Ragnarok was upon them. So it was that Loki cast a veil of enchantment over his mighty brethren. The evil one deemed that the forthcoming battle of Ragnarok lay too much in the favor of the good. And while the gods were under his enchantment, Loki crept into the great hall of Valhalla to steal those weapons that would save the day. He left Valhalla, carrying Odin's sword, Frey's spear, and Mjolnir, Thor's mighty hammer. When the gods awakened, they were sore distressed. They knew that Loki had stolen their weapons and cast them down upon the earth. During the age of Ragnarok, the gods were unable to walk upon the earth, lest they become mortal and thence lose all their powers. It was not until Frey offered up a plan to retrieve the weapons that the gods were placated. Odin was pleased. The hero, Heimdall, volunteered himself immediately to the task in hand. He traveled to the edge of Valhalla with Thor, who raised a vast storm across the heavens. Down below, in a Viking village at Norway's northern tip, a small hut is illumined by the storm, as though selected by it. The following morning, Ingrid awakens, distressed to discover that she is full with child, and the saga begins.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.